the Tri-State News Channel. And now, Chuck Scarborough, Michelle Marsh, Janice Huff, and Ben Berman. This is News Channel 4 at 6.
Hitman or Holy Man? Can this minister's tales of his life in the mob be trusted? A former New Yorker is traveling the country telling church groups a dramatic story of his journey from mafia to minister. Tom Papania's tale resonates with believers. The mob experts say it just doesn't ring true. Tony Aiello has the story.
On a January night in Georgia, inmates from the local jail join a capacity crowd to hear a story of crime and redemption straight from the streets of New York. Tom Papania says his words have helped save countless souls. Millions have listened, in person, on the James Dobson radio program, and on a video of Papania's life story, from mafia to minister.
By the time I reached 30 years old, I was the third highest ranking member in the Gambino family.
Papania says at age 15, he robbed crime family boss Carlo Gambino, who spared his life and shared a secret.
My grandfather was Joe the Boss, Joe Mazzaria, who the FBI says was responsible for bringing the mafia from Sicily into this country. This man that spoke to me was Carlo Gambino. He told me he was going to take me on like a son.
Papania says he learned well, became a millionaire New York mobster, trusted by new boss Paul Castellano, feared and respected by everyone else.
Even Carlo Gambino, when he was alive, he said to me, "Don't you have any weaknesses?"
Well, our investigation shows Papania may have a weakness.
That was the third closest to Paul Castellano.
A weakness for exaggeration. We met with him outside Atlanta, where he started a ministry a few years ago.
What do you think God would think of me if I had to go out there and lie to win people to him?
You don't tell any lies in this tape.
No.
It's all true.
Yes, Tony, it's all true.
Well, our investigation found many discrepancies. Here's just one. On the tape, Papania says the mob sent him to Kansas in 1965 to shoot two men.
I went there, shot both the men.
Papania says the mob turned him in to test his loyalty, but he kept his vow of silence while spending 5 years in a brutal prison for the shooting.
When the law was law, the more they could trust me.
In fact, court records show Papania did not shoot two men in Kansas, though he did commit two burglaries there. And as for his mafia connections, during a 1987 trial in Atlanta, Papania, by then a born-again Christian, denied under oath he was a member of the mob.
They're asking me, "Are you a member of the Gambino family?" In 1987, I was not.
A prosecution source says Papania was asked about past associations and testified he had nothing more than informal ties to the Gambino family. A law enforcement source says Papania was friends with Castellano's bodyguard, but the source calls Papania a mob wannabe.
Most of it seems to be in his imagination, as far as I can tell.
John Jay College organized crime expert Jerry Capisi has studied and written extensively about the Gambino family.
Except for this ministry that Papania runs, I haven't heard any mention of him at all in any connection with the Gambino crime family.
Papania now admits getting some dates and events wrong in his Christian testimony, but...
So I made a few mistakes with a few words. But all the things that I said happened in my faith, you can bet your life happened.
After our interview, Papania said he could take me to his office and show me a half dozen letters from Hollywood studios, offering him thousands and thousands of dollars for the rights to his story. But when we went to his office, Papania couldn't find the movie offers. He promised to fax them to me in New York. He still has not. Tony Aiello, News Channel 4.
Papania's attorney says a judge may have expunged the record of that shooting in Kansas when he allowed Papania to enter the service rather than serve jail time. Tonight at 11, we have more from Tom Papania defending his claims against mob experts who say they just don't ring true.
And next on News Channel 4.
In a culture fascinated by the mob, a former New Yorker is finding a lot of willing listeners. We first told you at 6 about Tom Papania, who claims he scaled the heights of the Gambino crime family, then gave it all up and God saved him. Mob experts say it's a very tall tale indeed. Tony Aiello reports.
For the few exceptions where a slip of the tongue, a wrong word here and there, basically the story is true.
Evangelist Tom Papania defending the claims on his widely distributed videotape called From Mafia to Minister.
By the time I reached 30 years old, I was the third highest ranking member in the Gambino family.
Papania claims to have been a trusted associate of New York mobsters Carlo Gambino and Paul Castellano. Says he committed crimes.
I went there, shot both the men.
And made millions of dollars during a notorious mafia career.
Even Carlo Gambino, when he was alive, he said to me, don't you have any weaknesses?
Well, our investigation shows Papania may have a weakness for exaggeration.
Most of it seems to be in his imagination, as far as I can tell.
Mob expert Jerry Capisi says in his extensive research into the Gambino family, he's never come across Papania's name.
He was not a major player in the mob, or even a major player among mob wannabes, as far as I can see.
Our investigation found many discrepancies in Papania's story. Some are small.
They came to this country and
he often tells audiences his parents were born in Sicily. He admitted to me they were born in New York. And larger discrepancies, such as his claims involving the 1982 kidnapping of an Atlanta man named Carl Coppola, who was held captive for 3 weeks by several men until, Papania claims, he made a phone call.
I was much higher up in the family than they were, and they had to listen to me. They didn't have a choice. They let him go.
According to press accounts and court records, Coppola was not released on Papania's orders. He was rescued in dramatic fashion by police. Another discrepancy, Papania's claim to have shot two men in Kansas, is flatly contradicted by law enforcement records.
You see, you're not just saying the pressure I'm under. When I've got to put this testimony in 60 or 90 minutes, I'm going to make mistakes.
Papania insists the gist of his story is true, but says he'll soon update his video to clean up some slips of the tongue and clarify his position in the Gambino family.
I was the third closest to Paul Castellano, not the highest.
It's pretty easy to say anything you want about your relative closeness to a guy who's been dead for 15 years.
Mob expert Jerry Capisi thinks Papania is playing on a cultural obsession with the mob to build his ministry.
There is a fascination with the mob. There is a desire by some people to have something to believe in, and he's made it so.
When people hear the truth and know the truth, that's what sets them free. And we've had enough lies throughout the years. We need the truth. I'm out there doing nothing but good from the goodness of my heart, okay? Giving more away than I'm getting. What is wrong with it? What am I doing wrong?
Tony Aiello, News Channel 4.
The Papania story probably reached its greatest audience in December of 1996 on the popular Focus on the Family Christian radio show. The ministry says it got thousands of requests for copies of Papania's testimony. It no longer provides the copies, though, citing recent controversy over Papania's claims.